If we would not have been able to launch this automation, the pandemic would have been a very, very different place. If you look at Asia and Pacific as a whole, there was only two banks who basically loaned money to government to pay for vaccines. If ADB would not have been so advanced in this cloud project and its automations, it's quite possible that it would have been more, substantially more difficult to be able to provide vaccines to a lot of developing countries in Asia.
For us, our main driver was actually resiliency. So we wanted to make sure that whatever happens, the ADB would survive, and the most logical decision to go for that is to make sure that we are as resilient as possible, and that meant moving into the cloud. And I guess it tied very nicely to our plans to adopt digital transformation within the next 3 to 5 years. When COVID hit, as all organizations, everybody was blindsided, and literally for the ADB, overnight, our headquarters closed down. But at the same time, ADB never closed its doors to its clients. There is an urgency for us to move faster, to build quicker solutions. We were so sure about Red Hat. We liked the way that Red Hat had no agents. We knew that we wanted Ansible before configuration management. We were using Terraform for day zero infrastructure. For day one to day end infrastructure, we are going to use Ansible for anything that's going to change. So for us, it was a very good marriage. Terraform actually works really well with Ansible, and we love all of the integrations that both platforms are given. In our data center, there's probably more than 2,000 configuration items. If we didn't do it in an automated way, that knowledge is probably stuck on somebody's brain instead of shared and democratized to everybody.
Using Ansible Automation Platform, we made sure that the container images are immutable. So in that sense, we know and we trust that the platform will perform the playbooks in a very consistent way. The entire Ansible infrastructure has been provisioned in Azure. That meant that we can utilize Azure resources. The benefit there would be the scalability of the infrastructure. We can easily scale in and scale out.
If tomorrow ADB decides, like, hey, you know what, we want to be more resilient, let's use Hong Kong as a backup region. For us, it's a single click. We have not only immortalized the blueprint of ADB's infrastructure as code with full audit trail, with full history, with full understanding with everybody why we're doing certain things, but also we are making sure we are future-proofing our direction to be able to be as nimble as possible.